people shall be troubled at midnight and pass away, and the mighty shall be taken away without hand. Can't stop this. The Most I call for you, this your time. You done. For his eyes are upon the ways of man, and he seeth all his goings. And that's what a lot of people don't realize. Job didn't realize. He just thinking he's going to follow the letter of the law. I said, no. You got to have faith in the Most High. You got to get the Most High of glory. For his eyes are upon the ways of man, and he seeth all his goings. There is no darkness, no shadow of death, where the workers of iniquity may hide themselves. For he will not lay upon man more than right, that he should enter into judgment with the Most High. He shall break in pieces mighty men without number, and set others in their stead. Therefore he knoweth their works, and he overturneth them in the night, so that they are destroyed. He striketh them as wicked men in the open sight of others, because they turned back from him and would not consider any of his ways. They're saying under the law. So he's going to get them. I believe that. See? And would not consider any of his ways. Have faith in the Most High. In the fear of the Most High. So that they cause the cry of the poor to come up to him, and he hear the cry of the afflicted. By them being so wicked, he calls the cry of the poor and the afflicted to come up to the Most High, and he hear that cry. When he giveth quietness, who then can make trouble? We don't have rest, brothers and sisters. Who then can make trouble? And when he hideth his face, who then can behold him? Whether it be done against a nation or against a man only. Hear that? He deal with nations. He deal with one man at a time. That the hypocrite reign not, lest the people be ensnared. The hypocrite reign not. People are entrapped in religions and so forth. Surely it is meet or right to be said unto the Most High, I have borne chastisement, I will not offend any more. That which I see not, teach thou me. If I have done iniquity, I will do no more. If I have sinned, I will sin no more. That which I see not, teach me. Should it be according to thy mind? Should it be according to the way you think? He will recompense it, whether thou refuse or whether thou choose. And not I, therefore speak what thou knowest. Let men of understanding tell me, and let a wise man hearken unto me. Job has spoken without knowledge, his words were without wisdom. My desire is that Job may be tried unto the end because of his answers for wicked men. For he added rebellion unto his sin. He clapped his hands among us and multiplied his words against the Most High. See, that's what you gotta understand. This is what he was doing. And not giving the Most High the praise for everything. Elohim spake moreover and said, thinkest thou this to be right, that thou said, my righteousness is more than the Most High's? Woo. So you think this is right, to say your righteousness is more than the Most High's? But thou said, what advantage will it be unto thee? And what profit shall I have if I be cleansed from my sin? I will answer thee, and thy companions with me. Look unto the heavens and see, and behold the clouds which are higher than thou. So look into the heavens and see, and behold the clouds that's way up in the sky. If thou sinnest, what dost thou against him? Or if thy transgressions be multiplied, what dost thou unto him? What doest thou unto him? Breaking his laws. If thou be righteous, what givest thou him? Or what receiveth he of thy hand? What you gonna give him? Thy wickedness may hurt a man as thou art, and thy righteousness may profit the son of man. By reason of the multitude of oppressions, they make the oppressed to cry. They cry out by reason of the arm of the mighty. But none say, where is the Most High my Maker, who giveth songs in the night, who teacheth us more than the beasts of the earth, and maketh us wiser than the fowls of heaven? There they cry, but none giveth answer, because of the pride of evil men. No answer because of the pride of evil men. Surely the Most High will not hear vanity, neither will the Almighty regard it. Although thou sayest thou shalt not see him, yet judgment is before him. Therefore trust thou in him. But now, because it is not so, he hath visited in his anger, yet he knoweth it not in great extremity. Therefore doth Job open his mouth in vain. He multiplied words without knowledge. Cutting, going into him. Elihu also proceeded and said, suffer me a little, and I will show thee that I have yet to speak on the Most High's behalf. So, suffer me a little while longer to speak to you. I'm going to show you that I have the Spirit of the Most High in me. I will fetch my knowledge from afar, and will ascribe righteousness to my Maker. For truly my words shall not be false. He that is perfect is in knowledge is with thee. Behold, the Most High is mighty, and despises not any. He is mighty in strength and wisdom. He preserveth not the life of the wicked, but giveth right to the poor. He withdraweth not his eyes from the righteous, but with kings are they on the throne. Yeah, he doth establish them forever, and they are exalted. And if they be bound in fetters, and be holden in cords of affliction, then he showeth them their work, and their transgressions, that they have exceeded. They have sinned against him. He openeth also their ear to discipline, and commanded that they return from the iniquity. If they obey and serve him, they shall spend their days in prosperity and their years in pleasures. But with this condition, if they obey not, they shall perish by the sword, and they shall die without knowledge. But the hypocrites in heart, hypocrites in their mind, saying one thing and doing something contrary to the laws of the Most High. But the hypocrites in heart heap up wrath. They cry not when he bindeth them. They die in youth, and their life is among the unclean. He delivereth the poor in his affliction, and openeth their ears in oppression. Even so would he have removed thee out of the strait into a broad place, for there is no straitness. And that which should be set on thy table should be full of fatness. But thou hast fulfilled the judgment of the wicked. Judgment and justice have taken hold on thee, because there is wrath. Beware lest he take thee away with his stroke. Then a great ransom cannot deliver thee. So beware the Most High kill you. Say, will he esteem thy riches? No, not gold, nor all the forces of strength. Desire not the night when people are cut off in their place. Take heed, regard not iniquity, For this hast thou chosen rather than affliction. Behold, the Most High exalted by his power. Who teaches like him? Who teaches like the Most High? Who have enjoined him his way? Or who can say, thou hast wrought iniquity to the Most High? Remember that thou magnify his work, which men behold. Every man may see it. Man may behold it far, far off. Behold, the Most High is great, and we know him not. Neither can the number of his years be searched out. See? Neither ancient of days. And that's the scripture, verse 26, proves that the number of his years cannot be searched out. For he maketh small the drops of water. They pour down rain according to the vapor thereof, which the clouds do drop and distill upon man abundantly. Also, can any understand the spreadings of the clouds or the noise of his tabernacle? Behold, he spread of his light upon it and covered the bottom of the sea. Hear that? It's the Most High we serve. For by them judges he the people. He giveth meat in abundance. With clouds he covered the light and commanded it not to shine by the cloud that cometh between it. The noise thereof sloweth concerning it. The noise thereof showeth concerning it. The cattle also concerning the vapor. Chapter 37. At this also my heart trembled, and is moved out of his place. Hear attentively the noise of his voice, and the sound that goeth out of his mouth. He directed it under the whole heaven, and his lightning unto the ends of the earth. After it, a voice roared. He thundered with the voice of his excellency, and he is not stayed them. When his voice is heard, Most High thundereth marvelously with his voice. Great things doeth he, which we cannot comprehend. Most High voices in that thunder. Who can understand the words of the Most High in thunder? For he said to the snow, be thou on the earth, likewise to the small rain, and to the great rain of his strength. He sealeth up the hand of every man, that all men may know his work. Then the beasts go into dens and remain in their places. They know how to hide. Out of the south cometh the whirlwind, cold out of the north. By the breath of the Most High, frost is given, and the breath of the waters is great. Also by watering, he wearieth the thick cloud. He scattereth his bright cloud, and it is turned round about by his counsels, that they may do whatsoever he commanded them upon the face of the whole in the earth. Commanded them upon the face of the world in the earth. He causes it to come, whether for correction, or for his land, or for mercy. Hearken to this, O Job. Stand still. Consider the wondrous works of the Most High. Dost thou know when the Most High disposed them and caused the light of his cloud to shine? Dost thou know the balancings of the clouds, the wondrous works of him which is perfect in knowledge? How thy garments are warm when he quieteth the earth by the south wind? Hast thou with him spread out the sky, which is strong and as a molten looking glass? Teach us what we shall say unto him, for we cannot order our speech by reason of darkness, not knowing. Shall it be told him that I speak? If a man speak, surely he shall be swallowed up. And now men see not the bright light which is in the clouds, but the wind passes, and here and cleanseth them. Fair weather cometh out of the north, with the Most High's terrible majesty. Touching the Almighty, we cannot find him out. He is excellent in power and in judgment, and in plenty of justice he will not afflict. Men do therefore fear him. He respecteth not any that are wise of heart. Respect no one that's wise in their own mind. Listen. Job 38. Then the Most High answered Job out of the whirlwind and said, Who is this that darkeneth counsel by words without knowledge? Gird up now thy loins like a man, for I will demand of thee, and answer thou me. Gird up your loins like a man, for I will demand of thee, and answer thou me. Where was thou when I laid the foundation of the earth? Declare, if thou hast understanding. So where was you when I laid the foundation of the earth? He said, declare if you have understanding. Who have laid the measures thereof, if thou knowest? Or who have stretched the line upon it? Whereupon are the foundation thereof fastened? Or they fastened together? Or who laid the cornerstone thereof? When the morning stars sang together, and all the sons of the Most High shouted for joy, or who shut up the sea with doors when it break forth, as if it had issued out of the womb? When I made the cloud the garment thereof, and thick darkness the swaddling band for it, and break up for it my decreed place, and set bars and doors, and said, Hitherto shall thou come, but no further, and here shall thy pride out high ways be stayed, as thou commanded the morning since thy days, and caused the day spring to know its place, that it might take hold of the ends of the earth, that the wicked might be shaken out of its place. It is turned as clay to the seal, and they stand as a garment, and from the wicked their light is withholden, and the high arm shall be broken. Hast thou entered into the springs of the sea, or hast thou walked in the search of the depth? Have the gates of death been opened unto thee, or hast thou seen the doors of the shadow of death? Hast thou perceived the breath of the earth? Declare it if thou knowest it all. Where is the way where light dwelleth? Where is the way where light dwelleth? And as for darkness, where is the place thereof, that thou shouldest take it to the bound thereof, and that thou shouldest know the paths to the house thereof? Knowest thou it? Because thou wast then born. Or because the number of thy days is great? Hast thou entered into the treasures of the snow? Or hast thou seen the treasures of the hail, which I have reserved against the time of trouble, against the day of battle and war? By what way is the light parted, which scattereth the east wind upon the earth? Who have divided a water course for the overflowing of waters, or way for the lightning of thunder to cause it to rain on the earth where no man is, on the wilderness wherein there is no man, to satisfy the desolate and waste ground, and to cause the bud of the tender herb to spring forth? Hath the rain a father? Or who hath begotten the drops of dew? Out of whose womb came the ice in the hoary frost of heaven? Who have gendered it? The waters are hid as with a stone. and the face of the deep is frozen. Is thou buying the sweet influences of Pleiades, or loose the bands of Orion? Can thou bring forth Maserat in this season? Or canst thou guide Arcturus with his sons? Knowest thou the ordinances of heaven? Can thou see, set the dominion thereof in the earth? Canst thou lift up thy voice to the clouds, that abundance of waters may cover thee? Canst thou send lightnings, that they may go, and say unto thee, here we are? Who hath put wisdom in the inward parts? Or who hath given understanding to the heart? Who can number the clouds in wisdom? Or who can stay the bottles of heaven? When the dust groweth into hardness, and the clods cleave fast together, will thou hunt the prey for the lion, or feel the appetite of the young lions? When they couch in their dens, and abide in the cover to lie in wait? Who provided for the raven his food, and his young ones crying to the Most High? They wander for lack of meat. The Most High is bringing it to Job. So I'm gonna stop right there. And we're gonna deal with 39, 40, 41, 42. And I'll go back and preach up a lot of what I just read. The next lesson. So I hope that was edifying. I hope you got a lot of what it is that can edify us today in looking at how Job was acting according to his own righteousness in his own mind. You see, you give no glory to the Most High in a proper way, because surely you can say, okay, we gave Most High a little credit here, but that's where you're at. That's where the Pharisees were. That's why I went through all the things in the Old New Testament, the Old back and forth, to show you a lot of how to be and how not to be. I hope you see that it's clear. You know, we've got to humble ourselves before the Most High and give him all the glory. He deserves all the glory, because he's the one that brought that upon Job. And he knew, like none of us knew, and no one knows until you really go into it and look at what is the reason why this is going on, because of the fact that Job was considering himself righteous. But when the Most High touched him, you see everything changed. You start to get the thoughts of Job. And a lot of the thoughts that you have, the Most High already know, he reveals them. It's just a matter of you being able to accept the change. Symbol. I must go to this, must go to the spirit is drawing me to, in 2 Corinthians 5:17. Therefore, if any man be in Mashiach Elbashan, or be rolling by Hashem Mashiach Elbashan, in the spirit of the anointed Savior, he is a new creature. Old things are passed away. Behold, all things are become new. You got to change. Romans 12:2. And be not conformed to this world, but be transformed by the renewing of your mind, the way you think, that ye may prove what is that good and acceptable and perfect will of the Most High. And that is, keep his commandments and have faith in Mashiach HaShem, in the glory of the Most High. See? Because, let the 2 Corinthians 5, and to you. For we must all appear before the judgment seat of Mashiach El Shaddai, that everyone may receive the things done in his body according to that he hath done, whether it be good or bad. See, that's the judgment. Everybody will be judged, whether or not they've been righteous. Whether it was good or bad. What's good? We're all going to be judged here with Mashiach El Shaddai. What's good? Romans 7 and 12. Wherefore the law is holy, and the commandment holy, and just and good. So we may judge by how we keep the laws of the Most High, and also how we have faith in them, in Mashiach El Shaddai. Revelations 14 and 12. Here's the patience of the saints, we the children of Israel. Here are they that keep the commandments of the Most High and the faith of a Mashiach El Shaddai. See, they both got to go together, people. You can't have one without the other. So, hopefully that was edifying, and we'll continue the next time. So, Shabbat Shalom.